So we have a triangular face, like a plate, perhaps a plate of metal or something like that, submerged into a tank of water, so that the top of the plate is 2 meters below the top, the water level. Our plate's 5 meters wide, 10 meters tall, and we want to find the hydrostatic force on this plate. So we want to find hydrostatic force. So that is the force due to water pressure, and pressure of water depends upon the depth. So the pressure is going to be the density of the medium, so density of water here, times gravity, times depth. The density of water working in meters is 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter. Gravity, we're going to use 9.8. So that's going to be our pressure equation. Force then, for hydrostatic force, will be pressure exerted over some area. Because pressure is typically measured in force per area unit. So like pounds per square inch, or here newtons per square meter. Then we'll multiply that by an area to find the total force. So, the trick here is this depth. The force here is going to be different, the pressure here is going to be different than the pressure there because of the depth. And so we want to break apart our face into pieces that are at a constant depth. And that means we're going to need to slice this, and we're going to have to specifically slice it horizontally. So we're going to slice this horizontally because everywhere on that slice, the pressure will be the same, because every point on that slice is essentially at the same depth. So we need to introduce a variable for the location of the slice. We can either use this measurement, we could use this measurement, or we could use the measurement all the way to the top. And because I find it the most convenient, I'm going to use this measurement here, the measurement from the tip of the triangle, and I'm going to call that length y. So, I need to find the width of my slice here, and for that I can turn to similar triangles. Right? We have our large triangle with a width of 5 and a height of 10, and then we have this smaller triangle here with the same angles, with a width of W and a height of Y. Solving for Y, W equals 1/2 Y. And now I know the width of my slice. Okay, so let's put this all together. So the force on this one slice will be density times gravity times the depth of the slice. How deep is this slice? Well, let's see. This distance is 2. This distance is 10. And this length is y. This is the depth. So it looks like we've got 2 plus 10 gives me a total of 12 down to the bottom of the triangle. And then y up from that. Looks like that leaves me with 12 minus y as the depth of my slice. So 12 minus y is the depth. And now, so this is depth here. And now we need the area of that slice. Right? So this was all pressure. Now we multiply that by area. So the area of this slice, it's a little rectangle. So we're going to take the width. The width is 1/2 y times the height. The height is some little change of y there, so some little dy. And there's the force on that one slice. So now, to find the total force, might be able to guess, we're going to integrate that. So now we're going to integrate 9,800, multiplying those two, times 12 minus y times 1/2 y dy. And we're going to add that up for all the slices on the triangle. So that's y values starting at 0 and ending at 10. And this integral will give us the hydrostatic force on that triangular face.